Hello, today I will show you quickly how to have a NetherPortal POI without having NetherPortal block in place. So we first start off with making a NetherPortal. A minimum size NetherPortal will do for this explanation. And we light it up. Now, Furigon made this very nice Scarpet script which will show the portal POIs and where they are. And as you can see, we have 6 NetherPortal blocks and we have also 6 POIs. If we now turn on the suppressor and we just break this block, this will get removed. Now we can break this block to remove all the other portals, and those will have their POI removed, and so we are just left with one portal POI right here. If we now teleport to the other side, to the Nether, right here, and we go through the portal, wait a bit, then right now you'll see that we arrive here right on top of the magenta concrete where the portal POI is. Now, as you can see, this is only a one-way portal, since to go to the Nether you need the physical Nether portal block in place. So this won't trigger going to the Nether, but to go from the Nether to here, the game only needs a POI, and it just links up to that POI, and that's why this works. If you want to get rid of this POI, you can, if you want, light up another portal, but you can also place a villager POI, like a composter, and then, as you can see, the POI got removed. If you now want to have, for example, more POIs, like a complete portal, and keep all the POIs but remove the complete portal, as you can see, we have 6 POIs again. We turn the suppressor. We remove this block. And then we need to suppress again to get rid of the last portal POI and the last portal block. And as you can see, we have 6 portal POIs left. So all the POIs from the portal are left, but none of the portal is there. And if we go to the Nether again, and we go back, you'll see this also works perfectly. Now you could also, of course, do whatever you want, and you can do pretty awesome stuff with this. And the handy thing is, you don't need any Nether portal in place, so for mob farms this can be quite useful, since you first of all don't have to worry about breaking the Nether portal block if you need a suppressed portal block, for example. And it can also be useful since if you need some TNT at the other side of the portal, you can just use that without having to worry about the portal. Yeah, that's all. Thanks for watching.